Well, it was very difficult, obviously. As I mentioned before, I have a unique perspective, and I absolutely understand and sympathize. As a former student athlete, if that would have happened to me, my reaction would have been one of real frustration and anger, so I understand it. At the same time, as John mentioned, you know, on a personal level, 2 years ago in April of 2009, when the chancellor gave me this opportunity, if I would have known that we'd have reached this point today, I'd have to tell you it'd been pretty difficult for me to take the job, because I'm a football fan. Football is in my blood, and I never could have envisioned a day when I would lead an athletic department that did not sponsor football. And so on a personal level, like John, I can't imagine it being more difficult. Professionally, however, John gave me a job to do, and he's my boss. And my job was to present with him a plan for financial stability and sustainability. And professionally, I felt like we had no other option. We didn't do this in a silo. We worked hard with a group of community folks. This was a 12-month process that looked at every one of our programs individually. We looked long and hard, and I assure you that we did not go into the process thinking or anticipating that we would have to discontinue any of our programs.
You know, one of the criticisms, though, is that you guys didn't handle this up front. You didn't tell people earlier. I mean, it sounds like you couldn't do that.
Well, that was a difficulty, and you're right. In a perfect world, I wish it would have been done a lot differently. And I will also tell you that I think we're, if not the first, the only institution that has now been reclassified or announced our reclassification to Division I per the new NCAA legislation. So I suppose and I recognize that there will be a period of time that passes and we'll look back and realize some real flaws and ways that I personally made mistakes and wish we could have had back. But the reality is that all of our actions were done thoughtfully. There was no malicious intent. It was all well-intentioned. And I think it's the thing that the NCAA, with this new legislation, really has to rethink, because it puts the administration in a terrible position. Because you can have all the hopes and dreams you want. You can have the whole community on board. If you do not have an official invitation, you don't have anything. And even through that process, even though there might be a verbal talk of February 18th, we had a verbal talk that that there might be some interest in the Summit League reclassifying us. We don't know whether we're being leveraged against other institutions. Were they truly interested? So you can't go at that point to the coaches and student athletes because you simply don't know. Quite frankly, when we made this announcement a couple weeks ago, we didn't have it passed by the Board of Regents, and yet half of our football team is out and transferring somewhere else. So I don't know how strategically we could have done it differently. I regret not getting in my car late Saturday night and driving out to Kearney to meet with Coach Denny face-to-face. I knew that there was an article coming out Sunday morning. I knew that based on social media and Twitter that we weren't going to be able to hold the information. So there were certain realities that we were given and that made it really difficult, but no less painful, and I acknowledge regrettable.
What about the donor situation? I mean, what is true and what is not true, I guess, as far as donors and people giving money to the university, I guess?
Well, we engaged an awful lot of people, and so certainly there are some vocal folks who are not real happy, but I can assure you that John and I have also received an awful lot of folks that are in support of it, and those folks that truly understand, and I think hopefully today, as a result of walking through the process, maybe people can understand a little bit better. The difficulty, again, was communicating the entire process, because there was no sense in communicating it without an official invitation. So certainly we have a lot of work to do. We have a lot of work back with our community and those that are affected and disillusioned in a sense with our program, and we will be reaching out to those people appropriately. It's going to take time. There will be people who will never ever support UNO Athletics again, and we understand that.
And how do you personally handle the personal attacks that have been against you?
It's been surprising, it goes with the job, and it's been a little more difficult for my wife and children, but that's the day and age in which we live in, and I understand it. It's okay, and I suppose you could listen to those things and allow it to direct your recommendations and policy, but we signed up for this thing to find a solution for UNO Athletics, and through a lot of hard work, we think we have.